So how does HSM fuzzing work? So the idea is that you look at the interface, the PKCS11 interface, and you look at what are the, is the correct way to use it, and then you change some of the parameters a little bit. So it's what's called mutation-based fuzzing. You take the real kind of input and then you change something to make it a little bit odd. So what you're trying to do is find a corner case of the implementation on the inside of the HSM where there's a bug. And you're trying to trip that bug to force either some memory corruption inside the HSM or just to get access to some functionality that you're not supposed to get access to. CryptoSense PKCS11 fuzzer works by using a functional programming language called OCaml to track the way that we're going to call these commands, and then using various ways of enumerating the different possibilities for calling the commands to very quickly come up with a set of fuzzing messages or calls to a particular interface that are most likely to trip the interesting bugs that are inside there. So we actually adapt the fuzzing algorithm as it runs. As we see interesting things happen when we get responses back, we use those outputs to generate more interesting test cases and seek out the dark corners where there might be a bug.